Welcome to Home Comfort Tactics. My name is Eric Gans, certified home energy auditor in Maryland. This is my podcast designed to help homeowners learn about a few things around the house that I think are important based on doing thousands of energy audits. There's a lot of key simple principles that are missed. And if you can get a grasp on them, you can really take control of your comfort and your energy efficiency. You may not be able to do all the things that need to be done, but knowing is certainly, in this case, you know, half the battle. So today, I want to tell you that I do think that building science principles are fascinating. I'm in and out of Maryland houses pretty much every day. And what I think makes really good sense is for the homeowners that I meet with, and I think this can translate over to any homeowner, that they have basic knowledge of three important things around the house and how they're connected. So, three building science principles every homeowner should know. Air changes per hour, energy efficiency, and indoor air quality. And I want to try to help you understand how they're all connected. So let's start with air changes per hour, and let's talk a little bit about exactly what that is. So air changes per hour can be defined as the amount of times the volume of air inside your home changes or exchanges with outside air. So it's basically, in a sense, it's your house breathing. If your house is calculated at 7 ACH, 7 air changes per hour, you can pretty much expect that on any given day, any given hour, that the inside air is going to change with the outside air 7 times. And to give you sort of a frame of reference, new construction, where they have the ability to seal everything up before things are closed off, the standard, the requirement, is 3 air changes per hour or less to pass the code. And it's important to understand that in a pre-existing house, these ideas, these concepts weren't really in motion back then. So our job is to more so do what we call retrofitting, where we want to reduce whatever air changes a house has per hour by as much as possible. And it also has to be cost effective. So also, to give you a frame of reference, I did a recent energy audit on a fairly standard size house in Maryland. And I have the figures here, so I'm going to kind of go through them with you. But the way that we calculate the air changes per hour for a house, we need two important things. First, we have to get the volume of the house, and that's pretty easy. You just have to get your square footage and your ceiling heights, and you have to do some calculations to get the total volume of the house. And then the other part that's a little harder to ascertain is to get a blower door test reading at a specific negative pressure, which is minus 50 pascals. So in this case, the house had 24,585, that was the volume of the house, and this was a particularly high or leaky house. Still haven't figured out why, but the 5505 at the test for the blower door, that is a very high number. The way we get the air changes per hour is we're going to take that blower door result, the 5505, we're going to times it by 60, so 60 minutes in an hour, and that's going to give us a total of 330,300. So once again, we're going to take the blower door reading of 5505, we're going to multiply that times the 60 minutes in an hour, and that gives us 330,300. Then we take the volume and we divide the volume into that number, and I've already done the calculation, and it was 13 air changes per hour. So that gives you a little perspective there. If a new house is being built, and it doesn't matter what size, it could be 3 times the size of this particular house, but after all is said and done, you are going to have to achieve air changes of three or less. But in this case, we have a house that's already got drywall, it's got ceilings in place, and we're talking about, you know, 13 air changes per hour. So that's my job, and that's kind of one of the important things of getting an energy audit is how do we reduce that number? That's one of the names of the game. So you got an understanding now, hopefully, of what air changes per hour are. So let's talk a little bit about how that relates to energy efficiency. And yeah, you know, energy efficiency, most people understand generally what that is. But the way that I want to look at it is controlled versus uncontrolled fresh air. And this is a big topic when I'm doing energy audits. This is really important to understand. Because you're going to get a lot of people in the trades that are going to tell you until they're blue in the face that your house needs to breathe and that the attic needs to breathe. And yeah, you know, we do want things to be ventilated, but there's a way that we can do that without compromising the efficiency of your house or the comfort in your house. So when we tighten up the envelope, and we don't allow the house to quote unquote breathe, which does again go against the grain of a lot of people, then we got to find solutions to create the right amount of ACH, air changes per hour, for healthy indoor air quality. And the key to this is making sure that the introduction of fresh air into the building is controlled so that less energy is consumed to maintain the good air, indoor air quality. And rather than allowing it to infiltrate uncontrolled, which is basically, you know, what a lot of people are sort of living in right now, which is going to cause your heating cooling systems to just have to work much harder. It's going to cause you to feel drafts. It's going to be more humid in the summer. So once again, tighten up the envelope, but we still have to get a stream of fresh air. And we do it in a controlled manner so that at the end of the day, you are getting enough air changes per hour to circulate, to keep things healthy, sustainable, you know, clean inside, but you're also using less energy and you gain comfort. So indoor air quality, what is it exactly? And I think this is the third thing that people really need to understand, because when you consider indoor air quality, it's important to know that measuring indoor air quality is not to measure the amount of particles in the air. Indoor air quality is actually making sure, again, that the building has enough fresh air in a manner that is cost effective. Good indoor air quality also goes a long way towards sustainability and longevity of the building's structural components. It's going to reduce humidity, high moisture contents. So it's really important to get these things right. And it's not too hard to do it with the right tools. And an energy audit is basically the Swiss Army knife of home improvement tools, because you can find out all of this information from a very small investment. It's actually with the tax credit right now, it's less than $100. There's a 30% tax credit up to $150, but in Maryland, the energy audit is only $100 for Pepco and BGE customers. So at the end of the day, you know, a tax credit of $30, your out of pocket is $70 for a great way to get a feel for where you're at. Sometimes I go into newer houses that, although they're uncomfortable because they're missing air sealing and different things in the right places, the newer houses are still built a little bit tighter. So sometimes, even without any improvements to the shell, houses are already in a deficit where they're not getting enough fresh air through the house. And it usually does correspond with people that have complaints about high humidity in the summer or uncomfortable temperatures in the winter and drafts and things like that. So all of this is connected to energy efficiency and comfort and, you know, just good indoor air quality. These things are all go hand in hand. So The best way to check all of this, as I said, is to get your energy audit. And if you're watching this and you're in Maryland, I do these energy audits all the time. Please go to my website, HomeTrustRemodeling.com, and just go right on there on the front page. You'll see a little tab where you can book your energy audit right online. And I think it's a great way for people to set up their energy audit, because we're going to spend time together when I get there, and I'm going to learn more about your problem and help you understand what's going on while I'm at your house. And it also allows you to check what days are available that best meet your schedule. So there's not a lot of back and forth. It's really easy to book it. It allows me to capture a little bit of information, and then I can start an email chain with you and we can connect that way. And if you have questions prior to the audit, we can certainly connect ahead of time. But that's the best way to get an energy audit through me. Thank you so much for listening. I hope this has helped you in some way, and have a great day.